Today was the day I would not only begin my last adventure of this month-long Canadian trip, but also my longest backcountry adventure ever. I knew it was a sign of good things to come when it started off with a roadside grizzly sighting. Welcome to Johnson Canyon. We are heading out on a 6-night, 7-day backpacking trip. This is the first part of the trip through this canyon, and we're going to see a large waterfall, beginning, middle, and top. And it's a little bit overcast. Felt a few raindrops already. It's warm, but I'm super excited about this trip.
So here's a look at an illustrated trail map right at the trailhead. Right now, we're down at the bottom. Basically, gonna hike up a ways. Gonna hit the lower falls, should be pretty cool. Gonna hit another waterfall. And we're gonna go up to the upper falls, which look to be the biggest. At that point, we'll probably intersect the main trail going to our camp. So it's only like 8 miles, which is, or sorry, 8 kilometers, about 4.5 miles to get to our first camp.
We would be doing a loop in the Sawback range of Banff National Park. What we didn't know is how crowded this beginning trailhead would be. We stopped here to get a shot of the lower falls. This is probably the most crowded trailhead I have ever set out on a trip from. It's a very popular attraction, apparently, but we'll be past all the crowds, I think, once we are past the waterfall. It is very beautiful.
We are now on the Ink Wells Trail, headed up Johnson Canyon. We're maybe 30 minutes from our camp, Larry's camp. And after seeing about 1,000 people on the boardwalks and passing a bunch of awesome waterfalls, we're in thick woods now and we haven't seen a soul in a while. So it's starting to feel like a backpacking trip.
We finally popped out of the trees and got the first views of our valley and the creek that we would be camping along that evening. We've made it to our camp. We don't know what site we're gonna take. I'm not sure how many sites there are here, but Joey is scouting it out right now. There are some other campers here. There's a creek nearby, so I have a feeling we'll find a good spot. It's kind of here in the trees. It is about 8 p.m. Luckily, I packed in a sandwich, so dinner will be quick.
We are using Cat's Nemo Hornet Elite two-person tent, which is pretty snug for two people, but it definitely works. And you're actually only allowed one tent per tent pad here in Banff. And then you can see we're on the outskirts of camp. Because of the bears, we have food lockers where we can store our food away from where we sleep. And the food's over that way a ways, along with the river, which you can hear.
All of these camps in the Canadian Rockies have been quite impressive. This one was beautiful, right along the creek with a fire pit area, benches, food lockers, and there are also toilets at all of these campsites, pit toilets. I don't know if I've mentioned that. Good morning from Larry's camp here in Banff. It is a beautiful morning. The sun is shining. It's nice and warm. We have a pass to go over today. It's called Mystic Pass. We will be traversing into Mystic Valley. The pass is about 2,000 feet in elevation, so in a short period of time, so it's going to be quite a bit of climbing. However, it will be a short day, only 6.5 miles, somewhere around there, to our next camp. And should be a great day, great weather, and we're just about to have some breakfast and coffee and hit the trail.
All right, we're hitting the trail, headed up to Mystic Pass. It's 6.5 kilometers up to the pass. For those of you in the States, 1 kilometer equals 0.6 of a mile. So 2 kilometers equals 1.2 miles. You can go from there. Anyways, 6.5 clicks up to the pass, and then it's gonna be pretty quick down. Thank you. starting to see a lot of bear scat, and this is a pretty big pile. I don't know how fresh it is. You can see my foot for size. It's pretty fresh. You can see how green everything is inside the poo.
We got to a spot where we could see the valley we came from and the thunderclouds moving in. We have made it to the top of Mystic Pass. It was quite a steep climb, and it's a warm, humid day, so it was very sweaty, but man, it is beautiful. Some thunderstorms are potentially rolling over. We did hear thunder, and there are some thunder clouds over us, but we have not seen any lightning or anything like that, so I think we're fine, and we're about to go down the other side and get to camp.
We're up here at Mystic Pass.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Pretty nice view.
Gorgeous.
This is our first look into the Mystic Valley. So we're going to be headed down that way. You can see our trail right over here. Can't quite see Mystic Lake yet.
As we were edging closer to camp, it started to drizzle on us and things got pretty wet and muddy. We had arrived at the Mystic Valley campsite, our camp for the night, with only 5 sites.
We're getting a combination of sunshine and rain at the same time. What do you think, Kat?
Come on, son.
Mystic Valley. How'd you like the hike today? What was your favorite part?
The pass.
Yeah?
Definitely the pass is beautiful. Yeah, it was tough for me because it was straight up going over the pass. I mean, hardly any switchbacks.
Yeah.
Very steep pitch.
A lot of steep pitches.
Yeah, coming down this side, there were some blowdown and things that we had to contend with.
It's muddy.
But we made it.
Yeah. 0% chance of rain today, too. So we're doing good. So tonight for dinner, we are doing cheese quesadillas, which is pretty easy to make. You have a frying pan like that. Two ingredients, cheese and tortillas.
After a very warm and satisfying dinner, it was time to call it a night and get to bed. Day 3 was a special day, so we decided to take our coffee and breakfast down at Mystic Lake. Good morning, it is day 3 and we are having breakfast and coffee here at Mystic Lake. It's beautiful.
I am making Kat some freshly ground coffee for her birthday. Aww. Using the jet boil French press.
And Sumatra.
Yeah.
Coffee, which is my favorite.
So what we did was we boiled water and then somewhere around here I got a little piece.
Right there.
Nice and clean, a little too clean, so we like to get a little dirt on it, help Kat's digestive system. But we'll take the little press, and coffee's been in there for just a little bit. Now we're going to press it down, and squeeze the coffee down, and the rest is going to be the drinkable coffee.
Fresh.
Yeah, so this is a jet boil French press.
Thank you, Joey, for carrying an extra heavy load to surprise me with my favorite coffee and some sweets and treats to make my birthday special. We're on the trail. We've gone about 2 miles, mostly through trees. We are headed towards Sawback Lake, but first we need to go over 40 Mile Summit. And it's been mostly through the trees. We've had a couple of openings. There are some thunderheads overhead, so we don't know if we're gonna get more rain today. It's a warm day. It's probably the warmest day of the trip. It's going to be about 72 degrees, I think. But it's nice right now, beautiful. And I'm excited to get to this next lake.
All right, we're about an hour into the hike so far. Very hot and sweaty hour. And now we're beginning our climb up to 40 Mile Summit. And not really sure what to expect out of the summit, except that it's probably gonna be in the trees. It's about a 300 meter climb. It's about 1,000 feet. And shouldn't be too bad. This could make it bad though. There have been a few trees down. We passed wardens on some horses earlier today. They had chainsaws. But they didn't go the way we're going, that's the problem.
If I'm being totally honest, this was my least favorite portion of the trip leading up to the summit. It was hot, it was sweaty, there were no views, and it was up and down roller after roller. But once we got into the open views, it was gorgeous.
Mm-hmm. What do you think, Kat? Was it worth the big climb up here?
Yes.
Still no bears.
Our camp for the night, the Sawback Lake Camp. It was beautiful here.
So today is Pizza Friday here in Banff, and we're gonna have the Elgato special, Backcountry Pizza. Step one is to use some butter or whatever you wanna use, maybe some olive oil. For this trip, we're using garlic parsley butter. This whole idea was spur of the moment. Kat was kinda sick of freeze-dried meals and wanted to do something a little bit different. So, we went into the grocery store in Canmore and decided to make backcountry pizzas. So, first step we're gonna do here is use some butter and lube up the frying pan. See, we have a nice fire going. Step two is to add the flatbread. Santosh, Canadian baked.
Garlic.
Yeah.
I had a feeling this pizza thing was going to actually work.
So we have let the bread bake for a little bit. Now we're gonna flip it. And we've actually flipped it a few times, I think. So that side that is facing up is hot. Kat's going to add some cheese to that, which is going to help with the melt.
Yeah, you want it warm so that the cheese actually melts.
Just going to add some pizza sauce first. We took pizza sauce out of a can, put it into a sparkly nice plastic water bottle. Save some weight. Next up, we have the mozzarella cheese, which has managed to last 3 days into this trip, despite the 80 degree heat.
It still feels cold. It still feels cool.
So we're adding some mozzarella cheese here. And that's the trick, is to melt the cheese without burning the bread, said every guy that ever cooked a pizza. Final step is to add the pepperoni.
This one's all super cheesy, gooey.
All right, Kat, how is it?
Awesome. Perfect.
What does that mean? What does it taste like? What's popping? Give us more
of
a description.
It's got like a nice, crispy,
crust, almost a little burnt, but it's perfect. Got a nice tomato sauce flavor. It's got lots of flavor because the bread's made like a garlic bread, and we also use garlic and herb butter, like, just to kind of crisp up the crust a little bit. And then the pepperonis are really good, fresh mozzarella cheese. It's awesome.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
We each had a nice big chocolatey brownie for dessert and then headed to bed. So we enjoyed having our coffee at the lake so much the prior morning that we decided to do it again, this time at Sawback Lake.
All right, Kat, it's day four, midway part of the trip. Today is the easiest day of the trip.
So you say.
It'll be easy. What are you looking forward to most about today?
Just having a chill day of hiking, because it's been a lot of uphill so far for the first 3 days. So it'll be nice to have some downhill, not a whole lot of uphill. Seeing some more open views maybe, because we've been in the trees a lot. But yeah, it's just really pretty area.
Chill day, she says. That's what we're gonna have today, chill day. So the first thing we're doing is headed down towards the Cascade River. It's about 6 kilometers down from here. This is our river. It's not very big, but we don't have to get our feet wet. So there is a bridge here.
After taking a lunch break at the Cascade River, we joined up with the Badger Pass Trail. Today would be some amazingly beautiful hiking. have picked out our campsite here at Block Lakes Junction. It is beautiful. We actually have some views and some peaks. Here's the tent pad, and it's super nice. I think it's going to be a nice, peaceful sleep. We've got a creek running right here. You can hear it, I'm sure. And yeah, I like this spot.
Quick take, Kat, what is your thoughts on this campground? How does it feel being out here?
This actual campsite, I feel, is a little bit wild and a little more spooky than the other ones that we've been in. I feel like we're further out there than we have been this
whole
trip.
We are.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And a lot of bugs, but that's been everywhere. After chilling in the tent for a bit, it was time to head over to the food prep area for dinner. On the menu, leftovers.
Here we go again.
Here with Chef Elgato. It's leftover night tonight. We pretty much can make anything we want to make with butter and cheese and tomato sauce and bread. What are you making?
Pizza.
Pizza.
Once again.
Pepperoni pizza.
Tonight we would add some cheddar cheese to the mix to spice it up a little.
All right, Chef, what do you think?
I think it's awesome.
The cheddar pepperoni.
Cheddar pepperoni, it's a winner.
It's a backcountry special.
Yep, absolutely.
Take a bite and tell us what you think. Oh yeah, look at those pepperonis.
Hear it crunch? It's awesome.
Day 4 is in the books. Another night of pizza, which is awesome to be able to have pizza here in the backcountry. Tomorrow is a big day, another big pass. I will see you then. Good night.
Cat. Day 5, what do you think of this view right here from camp?
Absolutely stunning. Love it.
We are headed up to Badger Pass this morning. It's about 7 kilometers up to the pass and about 700 meters. So I'm gonna be doing some steep uphill. It's like 100 meters per click. In cat terms, that's like over 2,000 feet of up to the pass. But we're getting an early start. We got great weather. It's kind of cooled off. We should have good views at the pass because it's gonna be much higher than our pass last couple of days. Should be getting up into the rocks, so we'll have good views, and then we're going to be dropping down maybe an hour to our next camp. Can't remember what it's called. It's at the junction, and so should be there in about 4 or 5 hours.
To interject here, I was very anxious and apprehensive about this day leading up to it. A hiker on day 2 said that Badger Pass was a pass he would not do himself because of the very steep pitch. I was hoping that he might have had passes mixed up. However, he did not. This was definitely the crux of the trip for me. Thank you. this point, I thought, surely that gentleman was wrong. It's not that bad, other than being a climb, which every pass is a climb. Okay, this is what he was talking about.
All right. We're at the pass, or maybe 20 feet from it. And on the other side of that divide, there's a glacier. Can't remember what it's called, but you'll see it if you look at the maps. It's a very steep, pitched trail. But it's a good trail. And we are about to get our very first view on the other side here. Yeah. So here's the sweeping view on the other side of Badger Pass. See our trail out there. Our camp's just gonna be at the base of this next junction. What do you think, Kat? I was elated to be on the other side, and honestly, it wasn't that bad. It wasn't life-threatening. I wouldn't have died if I would have fallen, but sometimes that fear of falling is really scary. I made up my mind a long time ago not to let fear stop me, and this time, it didn't. Besides, I would have missed out on these incredible views had I not done it.
Looking back up at the pass, right above Cat's head, the wind has finally calmed down. It's been pretty relentless for the last 20 minutes.
And then we drop down into an enchanted forest.
No bridges on this side of the pass. Gonna get your feet wet.
Made it to our site for night number 5, and if I was excited about last night's view, I'm really excited about tonight's view. Check that out.
Oh yeah?
Beautiful. And there's the tent pad right there.
I would say this campground definitely was tops for the most incredible view from our tent thus far. Unfortunately, the mosquitoes were very keen on this site as well, so we were covered up from head to toe and had plenty of bug spray handy.
You have mosquitoes all around my head? We're having a fire here at camp, not just for warmth, but we also want to cook on it. But another big reason is because mosquitoes are terrible at this campsite. I have no idea why they're worse here than anywhere we've been. But yeah, they are swarming by the hundreds. We're hoping the breeze kicks up, but the smoke from the fire seems to be helping a little bit too.
It's going to be another night of eating over a fire. And Kat is making me a pepperoni mozzarella calzone. I call it a calzone. She says it's a quesadilla. Also toasting up some English muffins. Put some butter on them. And yeah, it's going to be dinner.
It was a tough day and it was a great day. Good night. Day 6, we woke up to an absolutely gorgeous morning and would be heading to our final camp this day. After braving the mosquitoes at breakfast, we decided to head back to the tent to chill out for a few hours and listen to some tunes and enjoy the view.
Good morning. It is day 6. We have hit the trail. We are leaving our camp here, which was really beautiful. Might be the most beautiful views we've had from camp, and it was just a really neat campsite. Unfortunately, the mosquitoes were terrible, but we made the best of it. Today is our shortest day. We have 4 miles to go to Lake Llewellyn. So we kind of took our time this morning, just enjoyed and relaxed. It's about 1 o'clock, so we just definitely had a chill, relaxing morning. We didn't have any off days on this trip where we stayed at camp for 2 nights. So this was a nice time to kind of rest and recharge. And it should be a good day. It's supposed to rain later on today. The clouds are building right now. We'll see what happens tomorrow on our hike out. It says it's 100% chance of rain. So we'll see how that goes. It might be a wet hike out.
what do you want to say about this trip? What's been your favorite moment so far on this trip, and why?
Well, I would say yesterday going over Badger Pass was my favorite moment, because not only was it absolutely beautiful on both sides of the pass, my favorite pass, but it was the one that I was most intimidated about. And a hiker early on had said that it was pretty sketchy, it was pretty steep. And
that was Bruno down at Mystic Lake Campground. Yeah. He spooked Cat back on day two or three. Yeah.
So I had been thinking about it the whole time. And, you know, it was definitely a little spooky at the top, you know, when we were going over that ridge.
It's pretty steep, some loose rock, and then it was really windy. There was some big wind gust. It was hard to stand up.
Yeah, the wind was actually pushing me in the wrong way, not into the mountain, but away from the mountain. But once it was over and I was heading back down, I was just stoked, absolutely stoked, and it was just so beautiful on both sides, and that whole day was absolutely a stunning hike.
And now we arrive at our final camp at Lake Llewellyn. This was a popular camp, and there were lots of people around, so we did not break out the cameras at dinner. It's a bittersweet morning, day 7, our final day.
Gonna check in with Kat here. It's our 7th day, and your previous record for longest time being out was 6 days. So, how's it feel?
I feel pretty good. It went by actually faster than I thought it would.
Yeah?
I can't believe it's already over, except for our hike out today.
How's your body feel?
My feet are a little sore. I have a little bit of a sore ankle, but overall, pretty good. I mean, considering we've been hiking every day.
Yeah. Could you stay out another day, or are you ready to get out?
I could, but I'm ready for a cheeseburger,
yeah.
So
right.
I'm excited to get out.
All right. Well, lead us down the trail.
All right.
This trip was a loop, so it would end right back where it began.
We're just passing the ink pots now and starting to hail. Good news is we're back in the trees pretty much all the way.
I'll never forget this experience or the month that I was fortunate enough to spend time in the Canadian Rockies. It's definitely a unique and magical place, and one of the most beautiful I've seen. I will definitely be back.